Two in the search of East Fork State Park for 17-year-old Paige Johnson has ended. Nothing was found.
But the big story remains south of the river in the apartment of the man believed to have seen the teenager last. News5's Brian Hamrick gets an exclusive look inside, and what happened next is shocking.
Well, there was more search today at East Fork Park, but before that search, there was one here. We're inside the home of Jacob Bumpus. He's the man at the center of all this. We're learning more about him and more about what police believe was dried blood. We'll show you that and why at least one person absolutely believes that's not dried blood. Teams continued the search of the park, long and exhausting for them. Even worse for family of 17-year-old Paige Johnson, missing now almost a month.
The worst part is not knowing, the unknown, what we don't know.
Another unknown, Jacob Bumpus, the man in the middle of all this. We're learning more about him beyond his mugshot. He's a stage 4 cancer survivor. He's also Native American, Kiowa Indian. This is some of his artwork. Friends say they've known him to take up for women. They've never known him to hurt one. We've got access inside his home. This is the one police searched. Part of his parole violation was that he had weapons. His family says this is the weapon, this Native American tomahawk and quiver, something he had on his wall for years. Even though he's not been named a suspect, friends and family of Bumpus say so far he's been treated like one. And then there's what police believe could be the dried blood of Paige Johnson. Well, this is it. Well, the landlady who owns this building was so convinced this is not blood, she took her finger, wet it, put it here, and then put it in her mouth. She said, that is cherry Kool-Aid. Not only that, we found this nearby, a cherry Kool-Aid container, on it, a red substance. Police have not yet identified the red substance. Brian Hamrick, News 5.